Hey everybody. With the exciting new release of Element 3D version 2, one of the new features is shadows. It's one I'm really excited about, so I thought I'd go over how I set up my shadows in the warehouse scene using the shadow mapping. So let's jump in. But just before I start, another great feature is Element's new auto texturing ability. If you have the OBJ, the MTL file, and the texture maps together, you get the option to select diffusion, specularity, and the other textures, and Element can now auto load them. And it saves a ton of time. So on this model, we have a sky dome, and I'm just going to go and shut that off. You see that this has a lot of cool textures. I'm just going to reset the anchor point here to make sure it's flush with the grid, and we'll hit OK. This can sometimes take a little while when I first load the model. So first thing, we'll create a camera. I like to go with wider angle, like 24mm, hit OK, and we'll create a new null, and we'll make it 3D. I'm going to go into the top view and bring the camera in close to the null. And we'll parent it to the null. Now we'll go into the front view to center it in the warehouse. And now we can go to the active camera. So now we're inside and we can have a look around. You can see there's a fair bit of detail. So I'm going to go to the top view. And then I'll create a new light. We'll make it a spotlight. We'll make it 100% intensity and we'll hit OK. Now I want to shine my lights through the windows that were on the side of the building. So I'll position the light over here to the side. And I'll bring it in a little closer. Also towards the wall that the camera was facing. So you want to make sure that the light has cast shadows set to on, and then we'll go under the render settings in Element, go to shadows and click enable. Now it doesn't look super great at first, but the map size can be increased for a higher quality. Just as a note here, back in version 1, when you turned the light in the scene down, everything would go completely black. The reason it's not doing that here is because I'm using the physical shader. If you were to go into the preferences in Element, you can set which shader gets used when you import an object. I have mine set for the physical shader, but you can switch to the standard shader if you'd like. Now the physical shader always uses the environment to light the scene. This model doesn't show it as well as others, but in the presets you can change the lighting by selecting different environments. The environments will light the scene whether or not you have lights or not. This is a difference you want to be aware of, and I'll show you what to do if you don't quite get the results you're looking for. So hit OK. And I'll turn the light back on. So if you do want to darken the shadows, go into the physical environment and adjust the exposure. You can brighten or darken it. So you probably noticed that these shadows don't look very good, so I'll switch to the ray trace for a moment. and this is probably more like what you're expecting, since the lights are on the outside of the building. But shadow mapping works a little different. So I'll switch back, and what you want to do is go down here and click Use Back Faces. This is needed here because the outside wall's normals face inward. So now we have the samples and the blur radius, and if you lower the blur radius, it tightens the shadows. And the samples, of course, if you lower those, it gets a little messy. 11 seems to be a good number, but in this case, I'm just going to stay around 6. It's pretty good quality, and it renders a little faster and looks pretty good. I'm going to reposition the camera to look at this back corner. So now the cool thing is, if we go to the light and we hit P for position and start moving it around, we get this cool effect. You can simulate a helicopter flying over, kind of like what I was going for in my video. Or maybe it's a Columbia Record Club collection agency, whatever you like. Another thing too is, if you move the light far enough around, you can bring it inside the warehouse. If you go into the light and hit AA, you can adjust the cone angle and the cone feather amount. This makes it look kind of like moonlighting, so I'm going to go in and make it blue. Just going to drop the exposure down a little to darken the shadows. Another possibility is to duplicate the light, reposition it. And then it looks like you have a few light sources coming in. You could change the color to yellow to make it look a little like street lights. It's a little strong, but you get the idea. So I'll just turn that off. So I'm just going to create an adjustment layer and do a little color grading. Command-Shift-H or Control-Shift-H on a PC is what hides the controls on the window. Just makes it a little cleaner. And hit that again to bring them back. If you notice any aliasing, come down here and click multi-sampling. It's a little faster than super sampling, but if you need to, you can also use it along with super sampling. So on final note, if you want to soften your shadows, just turn up the blur radius. In this case, I prefer the shadows kind of where they were, so I'll just leave it there where it was. So that's about it, guys. Be sure to check out my other videos and tutorials, and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks so much for watching.